We have a very special guest right now, Capri Sweat, founder of the Medical Cannabis Outreach. The Medical Cannabis Outreach is holding a free educational seminar, well, many of them, on the legal Illinois medical marijuana program. For those of you on hold, hang on, we'll be taking your calls in a couple of minutes, but right now we want to take a break and talk about this program that's going to affect everybody in our city and state. Welcome to the show.
Hi, Wayne. How are you?
I'm doing quite well. So you're going to have these seminars. What is the actual law here? People aren't aware of, some are, but other people don't know what the law is in terms of marijuana in the state of Illinois.
That's right. We thank you for having us on today so we can get the message out there. A lot of people in the state aren't aware that even that medical marijuana is legal in Illinois. Medicine is actually growing right now in the state of Illinois and will be available soon to qualified patients. So we get out there and travel around the state. We give free educational seminars, and we try to drop those fears and stigmas and get people to really look at medical marijuana as a medicine and not so much as the stigma and the stereotype that surrounds it.
Well, I mean, it is a medicine, but it's also, I mean, you could loosely say that. If I go home on Saturday night and I'm stressed out from a long week and I decide to smoke a little bit of marijuana, it's medicinal in its own way psychologically, but that wouldn't qualify as medical marijuana. So what does? How do you? And oh, by the way, my back hurts. Do you know someone who can get me a prescription? No, I'm kidding. But how do you actually qualify? What would count?
Right, and actually, it's a bit of a strenuous process, and that's why how Medical Cannabis Outreach was born, was out of the application process. It's tough for a lot of patients. You have to have one of the 38. Debilitating conditions that's on the list that the state set out, and most of them are, as they signify, debilitating. So, but you have to go through a application process, and we have that down to a science. We help people every day free of charge to get through that process, and you have to jump through a few hoops, but we help you. We hold your hand and navigate you through, and we get people approved every day to the program.
So. How many hoops are there, and how difficult is it to get through? Because a lot of these people are sick. I mean, some of them. I mean, there's
that's right.
There are diseases, and then there are diseases. I mean, if you have somebody with a severe form of cancer, they're not going to want.
Right.
They're not going to want to jump through hoops. It might be easier for them to go call up their old dealer and say, you know, hey. Can you slip, you know, can you come over for a minute?
Right. Mm-hmm.
But then, of course, they put themselves in legal jeopardy and could end up arrested and sick, which is never fun.
Right. So, never good. Never good. And that's why we're out here trying to stop all of that. In states where medical marijuana is legal and has been for some time, there is a significant drop in black market sales. And that's what we're encouraging people is to get legal. Get your medicine legally. This medicine is high quality medication that is grown in controlled environments by specialists and industry experts, master growers. And we encourage people to come out and get on the legal program so that you're not hiding anymore and you can obtain your medicine, you know, as a safe legal alternative to a lot of narcotics and opiates and things like that that people are really tired of being on, frankly. We hear horror stories. We have many patients that are terminal. They're not sure if they'll make it to the dispensary's opening, but some of the dispensaries in the state will be opening here in the next several weeks. So we're encouraging those patients just to hold on to hope, and they're just looking for a better quality of life, and we're excited to give that to them.
Well, opiates are dangerous. They're very addictive, and one of the beautiful mm-hmm. things about marijuana, for a very small number of people, I suppose it could be psychologically dependent, but it doesn't have the physical properties of addiction like opiates that can ruin people's lives and have caused one horror story after another.
Absolutely, and that's where we see people come to us every day that are horribly addicted to narcotics, and we encourage them, and like I said, a lot of our patients are terminal, and that's why we're out here. The process is, first off, the doctors, the physicians in the state of Illinois are the gatekeepers of this program, and it actually states that in the law. The law was signed into law January 1st, 2014, by Governor Quinn. It's been a rough, slow start, but we're almost there where patients will get medicine.
Why has it been a rough, slow start? Who's been getting in the way?
Yeah,
Name names.
You know, you're going to call me out here, aren't you?
That's what we do.
It's tough because politics has gotten involved in this, to be honest with you. So we had a change of governorship, as everyone knows, and Governor Rauner needed to come in and review the program.
Well, if there's ever a buzzkill, it's Bruce Rauner.
Right. Exactly. And as you may know, but a lot of our listeners may not know, a medical advisory board had recommended 11 additional conditions to this list, PTSD being one of the main ones that had a lot of...
Yeah, we talked about that.
Yeah. And a full denial on those 11 conditions was extremely disappointing.
How could Bruce Rauner turn his back on our service members who risked their lives? They came back and they are having trouble readjusting to society. You know, it's kind of hard to go out to a place like Afghanistan and Iraq and kill people and see your friends killed or maimed. And it's psychologically debilitating. And marijuana, if it helps people who have trouble in a regular job come home and relax, it certainly can help somebody who was in the desert dodging IEDs. And for him to turn that down seems just downright short-sighted and cruel.
Absolutely. And we hear every day from veterans that are irate and just hurt by his decision. And there are a lot of rallies being planned and things like that where veterans are going to gather and, you know, let the governor know how they feel. But it was extremely disappointing that day for many people.
Yeah.
Really hurtful. And the only way really we can kind of explain it is there's got to be some, you know, some hands in some pharmaceutical pockets or, you know, something like that. We can't figure out why he would have went past the deadline.
Well, Big Pharma's freaking out because once marijuana is legalized everywhere in this country, that's going to be the drug of choice for most people because it has the least amount of harm.
And they don't benefit from it. They do not benefit from it right now. And so they'll, you know, do anything to kill it.
Yeah, and people think all the time of the crack dealer on the side of the street or the heroin dealer. And it's, as the Stones sang about a long time ago, Mother's Little Helper, you know, that's the prescription drugs that cause more damage than any other drug.
So much, so much. And in states where medical marijuana is legal, you see a 30% decrease in prescription drug use and misuse, overdose, you know, deaths and things like that.
What's the delivery mix?
The statistics are there. It works. People know it. And so they're starting to come out now.
What are the delivery mechanisms at these dispensaries? Is it Marinol? Is it a regular marijuana?
Oh, yeah. The dispensaries will not carry any Marinol. Marinol is a synthetic drug. It actually has no medicinal value, and actually none of the cannabis plants is in Marinol. So it's absolutely, what it does is give the psychoactive feeling of THC, but no medicinal value.
It's like Diet Pepsi.
None of the taste of regular
Pepsi, but anyway. When is the first dispensary going to open, and what does that mean for residents of Illinois?
Well, it'll be a great day for the residents of Illinois, and it'll be historic. And they'll open right now. There's no set date, but honestly, from just being on the inside of the industry, looking at probably right around the end of October, medicine's going to be available. 4 dispensaries in the state have gotten registered just in the last week and a half. And so they're really geared up. And as soon as that first harvest takes place, the dispensaries will carry flower, you know, marijuana bud, the regular type of marijuana we all know. But they'll also carry edibles, oils, you know, the concentrates, CBD, THC oils, things like that.
I cannot wait till the time comes when they say, this bud's for you. They're not talking about a beer.
Me either. That'll be a great day in this country, I'll tell you that, and a great day in Illinois, and we're excited about it.
Why don't we just legalize it already, and so we can pay our pensions without having to raise all these other taxes, a garbage tax, a property tax, a Uber tax, and it would just make so much sense to just legalize it, and plus they would cut down on crime dramatically because there'd be no black market to sell these drugs, and some of the people who are working illegally could get legitimate jobs where they're paying taxes, working in that industry, one that they're familiar with. It makes no sense.
It doesn't. It's a no-brainer to a lot of us out here, and it's mind-boggling. I actually am a legal patient in Colorado. I have been for 12 years. I have been prescription drug-free for over 22 years. I've had Crohn's disease for 33 years. So I'm a walking personal testimony. I medicate with cannabis only, and I do everything I want to do. And so anyway, but my point with this is that Colorado, I spend a lot of time there. That state is booming. I mean, crime's down. economy's up. There's building everywhere, new schools with air conditioning and state-of-the-art everything going in them, brand new roads.
They took a tax holiday because if you exceed the amount of revenue expected, they have to set it back to zero. It's complicated.
That's right.
But it means that they had one day where there were really no taxes on marijuana, and people were lining up like it was Space Mountain at Disney World to get on the ride.
Absolutely. Right, and they did so well on the budget in Colorado. We were all given a refund because of the marijuana, because of recreational marijuana. So it works in the economy, and it works socially. There has not been a social breakdown in Colorado. In fact, the opposite. You're seeing less alcohol abuse, less prescription drug and hardcore drug abuse, less domestic violence.
And we knew drugs were a big part of Colorado for a long time. After all, we saw Focus on the Family and saw what they stood for. We said these people have got to be on something. But
there you go.
James Dobson, right. he's got to be high. You can't come up with these weird things unless you are. How many people in Illinois are going to initially qualify? I know it's probably in flux right now, but do you have any estimate of how many people are going to be have the card or whatever it may be, card-carrying cannabis smokers?
Right. Well, unfortunately, way below the projections, the initial projections. We're supposed to be up into the, 100 to 200,000 patients by the time dispensaries open. And in fact, we're looking at about 3 to maybe 4 or 5,000 patients will be approved by the time some of the dispensaries start to open. So that's how hard the process is. And that's how hard it is to get a doctor to recommend. That's what's really stopping a lot of this.
Well, you have federal drug laws.
Know about the program.
Well, right. You got the federal drugs laws, and they're afraid to get the wrong president. You had Chris Christie already threatening, if I'm ever elected president, I'm going to come in. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's just mad because he wants all the munchies for himself. But
exactly. So you wonder what his motive is saying something like that. It's ridiculous.
Well, he wants attention.
His family has left his state. Okay, they're refugees from his own state. They've up and got out of there where they can go and protect their children and get them CBD oils to help their epilepsy and things like that.
Well, he's looked, I've been to New Jersey. There's enough smoke there. That's probably what he's afraid of.
That must be what the problem is.
Yeah, he's already seen all the pollution.
It's not the right kind of smoke. It's smog. Yeah.
Yeah. So you said when the dispensary is open, but there's no exact date. Is there an estimate? I mean, when do you think they're going to be open?
I think right around Halloween is what we're looking at, when the first one will probably open in the state. Right around that third to fourth week in October.
That's gonna be a bad trip. Your first time smoking it for some of these people, and they see a bunch of people in Donald Trump costumes. That's enough to make them stop and never do it again.
Nobody wants to see that, whether you're smoking or not, I think. I don't want to see that anyway. But you're absolutely right.
So you're going to be having a lot of seminars. Talk about your seminars, and when are they, and what's going to be discussed there?
Well, we're canvassing Lake County right now, and Cook County. We're getting into Cook County as well. But right now, in this right tonight, I'm in Mundelein at 6 p.m. at the Baymont Inn and Suites, 517 Route 83. Like I said, at 6 p.m. And then tomorrow night I'm in Zion at 6:30 p.m. We're hitting little, even the smaller communities. We're trying to touch everyone and let them know we're out here. We're at the Zion Park District tomorrow night at 6 p.m. And then Saturday.
I thought you'd be at the Hyatt. Ha ha. Dad jokes. Dumb joke.
Yeah,
I know.
Good one.
It's the best I could come up with right now. Yeah, it's the best I could do at the moment.
I like it. And then this is even better. We're in Libertyville. The Liberty, we feel pretty liberated being able to do this. We're in Libertyville Saturday at 10 a.m. at the Libertyville Sports Complex. Free, open to the public, come on out, and you'll learn everything you want to know about medical marijuana. And maybe some stuff you don't want to know. You never know.
Excellent. Hey, thank you.
Talk about it all.
Thanks so much for what you're doing. You are doing important work and helping a lot of people. And if we could just get that Governor Bruce Rauner to get his act together. He's going after veterans who need help. I mean, what's crueler than that? This is a nasty guy. And I wish you luck having to deal with somebody like this who clearly needs a bong hit more than anybody I've ever met. That governor.
Absolutely.
Of ours.
Yes, and thank you for your support, Wayne. I really appreciate it.
It's just one issue I definitely support. Thanks a lot. This is the Wayne Besson Show. I will see you in just one moment.
The Wayne Besson Show.